The coronavirus is the biggest threat this country has faced for decades, and this country is not alone at this moment of national emergency. To stay at home, protect our NHS, and save lives.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, it's Chris here.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hi, yeah.
Hi.
Hi. My name's Yvonne Conroy, and I have the privilege of being the leader of St Philip and St James Church Drama Group in Oddown in Bath. In March 2020, we were at the peak of a pandemic called the COVID-19, which was spread throughout the entire world. Our lives were about to change forever as we were forced into lockdown. This meant that we had to stay at home to protect the NHS and save lives. The lockdown had a huge impact on our lives and how we communicated and carried out our daily basic needs to survive. The daily news briefings were terrifying, and people were scared and unsure of what was going to happen and what we were supposed to do. So this short documentary is how a small amateur dramatics group in a thriving community coped and supported each other through the hardest days of our lives. This is how our friendships developed, our attitudes changed, and we became stronger as a group. A typical year in the life of this group would be very busy, very fun, very productive. We'd be meeting together, doing things, writing things. Have a look at what sort of thing that we did the previous year. This is our year in pictures. Then suddenly, everything stopped. Everything stopped. Life became difficult. And I think there was a real strain on people's mental health and their well-being. I asked a few members of my drama group, what did you find difficult during lockdown?
I really enjoy giving people a good hug, and I enjoy receiving them as well. So I really have found that difficult and have nearly slipped up on many occasions.
I found motivating myself during this time to be very hard, and also not being able to hug my mum.
Well, is missing family and friends and seeing them regularly. That's been the hardest thing.
Doing everything, all my schoolwork online since, because we've been doing schoolwork online before, but it's changed to every single work I've done has been online instead of being in a work environment and doing things on computers or iPads. It's just been doing most things on my phone, which has been quite hard.
Not seeing family, definitely not seeing the grandchildren, Thomas and Fiona.
Space. Where we live is quite small, but we are very blessed to have a gorgeous garden. However, getting out and about with my daughter and making sure that she is well exercised and has run off steam, so that when back in the house and doing home learning, that that's actually been productive.
Without doubt, not being able to see my family. They all live a long way away.
Homeschooling.
I haven't seen people that have off and I haven't been able to get out a month.
Not being able to hug friends and family.
Is being on my own all the time. It's not that I really get lonely, it's more that not being in touch with people.
I didn't like the adjustment to start with the change. I found that very difficult to deal with, and not being able to travel, that had a huge effect on me. I like travelling, I like getting in my car and shooting down the motorway, driving to places, especially on the weekend, and obviously we couldn't do that.
You don't realise how important meeting other people is until you can't.
Has definitely been that I can't see my friends, and that I can't go to school because it's hard because having to work things out on your own, it's because I'm really unorganized, so it's really hard to keep organized.
Home working, it's really quite tough to be doing a job when the equipment is in the office and you've got to find lots of workarounds. It's also really distracting working from home.
My life basically evolves around people, so not seeing them has become quite tough.
Giving all my friends and family a hug.
Homeschooling my 7-year-old grandson.
It's not being able to hug any of my friends or family that are not in my bubble.
As you can see, for my little Amdram fam, there was lots of things they found difficult. Moving forward was so important to focus on maybe some of the highlights and the good things that were happening. My highlights were actually found in the most unusual places. Slowing right down and stopping and just being creative and rethinking things was a huge highlight for me. I asked some members of the drama group, what were your highlights during lockdown?
Dyeing my hair pink, because I would not have been able to do this if I was still at school.
Probably the biggest highlight is that it's been an opportunity to get much better at meditating every day.
One of my highlights is every week me and my family do a family quiz each week and see who wins. Usually not us.
It's creating the digital archive of all the drama group shows since they began in 1958.
I think not having any schedule and time pressures, that's been great, and it's also given Karen and I time to settle down into our new old home that we've come back to after 22 years.
I've really enjoyed doing some crafty stuff in my free time. The free time has been really good to really work on myself and focus more on myself. It's really made me realise how my job is not the only thing I do.
Being able to learn new things and being new opportunities lockdown has brought me.
Getting closer to my family members. So me and my cousin have gotten quite a lot closer, and me and my friends have also gotten closer.
We've had Zoom contact with friends and family, and I've also done some puzzles, which I haven't done for a long, long time.
Slowing down and spending more time with Jeff, enjoying walking, gardening, and just being together.
It's having time to get on with my hobbies, my motorbike that I'm rebuilding. I've also had time to get involved with the MAT22 project at the church, which has been great.
Trying to think of activities to make every day kind of exciting and interesting. That's been really good.
I've never played so many games in my life, so I think that is a perk plus. Like, I think one of the best things was seeing my gran though, but I do enjoy playing all the games that I've got.
I think that music has been our saving grace, getting some music on, playing it during home learning, whilst out, even just kind of stopping and playing songs, mostly from Disney soundtracks, I'm not going to lie.
Being able to have Saturday night Zoom meetings with my siblings, being able to see that they're okay.
I think the extraordinary acts of kindness that have come to the fore during the lockdown. I've just seen so many crazy things that people are raising money and doing kind things.
Supporting my friends and doing up the garden.
There have been a lot of positives. I've liked the pause and the reset, as I keep calling it. Day-to-day life was very hectic and I was out of the house for a lot of the day. So that's obviously changed during lockdown. I've been able to kind of do some things that I've wanted to do for a while, catch up with more friends over video calls and things like that.
Spending more time at home with my dear wife Heather, and getting out of the rat race, slowing down, stopping, and more leisure time.
Some great highlights there that maybe wouldn't have happened had it not been for the pandemic and the lockdown. Helping each other to be positive is quite hard for some people. This is why every Monday evening we set up a Zoom meeting And every week it was different. Every week we tried to do something different. I asked some members of the group, what was their favourite Monday evening Zoom meeting?
Well, there's two really. There was the games night, and then there's the reading of the plays.
The script read-throughs, because I really enjoy reading through scripts. I find it to be really fun, and to be able to do that with my friends has been even better.
I've really enjoyed them all. They've been so varied, never a dull moment.
My favourite Monday night must be all of them, because I love talking to everyone and just seeing them.
They've all been great, because it's been fantastic to be able to meet up and chat to one another.
Probably games night, that was quite fun. But they've all been pretty fun, to be honest, so it's hard to choose.
But I really, really like the murder mystery. I think it showed everyone's acting ability, you know, their real strengths. And I saw sides to some of the people in the drama group that I never knew that they could do that kind of acting. And it was such fun to act things out and then get a result in the end. It was a wonderful thing to do.
Is probably the escape room, because that was really fun and we solved all the challenges.
The murder mystery, definitely.
The escape room was really good. I really enjoyed watching how different people work and how they solved the puzzles and how the puzzles were written as well. It was very well done. I really enjoyed that week.
I think there's a three-way tie for me between the escape room, the murder mystery, and the reading of the Roses of Iron play, which I found very moving and was really glad to come across that particular play that I'd not heard of before.
Probably has to be all the script reads that we do. I don't know why, I just like reading scripts.
Was the escape room, although I still have no idea how one of the other teams managed to beat us by quite that much.
But I would say either locked in a room. I really like the dance, kind of the dance sport, I guess you would say, put together by Chris and then Emily, the little routines. And then we had to like run around our house and find different things and a little bit of lighthearted humour and fun. Reading out the eames of trying to remember what the play was called, doing the script through read. That was absolutely fantastic. That was really good fun.
The village play, the one about the plague, I think I really enjoyed that. Though I like them all, so it's quite difficult to choose a favourite.
All of them, particularly at the end when we just get to be together.
Murder mystery, because it's really different and exciting.
The murder mystery was good fun. I really enjoyed that. Obviously the 1994 Tom and the Jabberwock script read through, that was also very comical. I enjoyed that. It was good fun to look back on what an old script was and go through.
Oh, the one where we put into two teams and played games. I just loved games.
Everyone liked something different, and that was important. The drama group has members ranging from age 11 to, well, there is no upper age limit. And we welcome everybody with the love of God in our hearts. And we care about each other. We set up a prayer circle for anybody that wanted prayer during this time. And I think members found that very comforting, knowing there was a dedicated group of people praying and supporting them through this terrible time. Being an amateur dramatics group, there's bound to be some song or film or show that they particularly found comforting during this time. My favourite songs were, there was one called See You Again by the Grey Havens, also Level of Concern, 21 Pilots. So I asked the members of my drama group, is there a song or a film that has helped you through this pandemic?
You've Got a Friend in Me, that was really, really good.
My daughter's been listening to Disney Princess album on repeat, so that's quite cheery.
Facebook funnies, as I call them, have kept me entertained.
Crossing the Rubicon by the Shikari is pretty good. That's helped me through, plus A Wasted Hymn by Architects. That's a really lovely song to listen to when you go through a rough patch. And a film that's helped me with lockdown has to be Lord of the Rings Extended.
Waving Through a Window from Dear Evan Hansen, that's kind of been quite a highlight one. I've been listening to the words of a lot of songs, so that one's kind of struck a chord with me a bit. I also like George Ezra, Paradise or Shotgun, either of those I think are really good songs, and again the words have kind of helped me through a few times when I've been feeling a bit low.
It must be Sister Act 1 and 2, I don't know why, they're just so funny.
Probably Into the Unknown from Frozen 2 would be a song that has really helped me, walking around the house singing it to myself like 90% of the time. Yeah, it's actually the words are very appropriate to this time, but I do really like this song anyway.
Not been one really, but I've enjoyed playing the guitar to a lot of Dylan songs.
But one would be You Will Be Found, and from Dear Evan Hansen, and Pray by Tara Perelli.
Rather than send me a Father's Day card this year, Charlie recorded a little song for me. It's a song I know well, and he just changed the words to be Happy Father's Day.
One song called Boys Will Be Bugs, which is just quite a relaxing song, so when things get like too much, I listen to that to help me relax. And then there's a song called Level of Concern, which is about the whole quarantine and lockdown and things. And yeah, it just like, that helps me to know that I'm not the only person going through all of this.
Vivaldi's Four Seasons. Even though I was trapped inside the four walls of my home, I could just close my eyes and be transported. There I was in a field full of flowers swaying in a soft breeze. Yes, Vivaldi kept me sane.
Well, I love listening to classical music, and I've enjoyed the recorded shows on YouTube from the National Theatre, the Andrew Lloyd Webber the Shows Must Go On series, also on YouTube, and the Royal Opera and Ballet.
Or Get Back Up Again by Anna Kendrick in Trolls. That's played a lot. And then another one that's really good is putting on 90s music. I've just asked Alexa to play 90s music, and it's taken me right back to a time when probably there wasn't much stress or worry in my particular life or household.
Well, actually, one of the things which has really helped me is not a song as such. It was the ripple of applause on a Thursday night as people said thank you to the NHS and the key workers for their sacrifice during COVID-19.
Lucy Spraggan, Stick the Kettle On.
The song Before You Go has been a very comforting song for me during the lockdown. It's just a really good song. And also Maleficent 2, I really liked that movie.
No surprises that they all said something different. This drama group has been a strong support for hundreds of people during the years, but we've never felt we needed each other more than 2020. I thank you all, and I praise God for his endless blessings. And what better way to end this short film, I love this, than the song that we put together with the help of Dave Atkinson and Niall Conroy, which gave us all a real boost when we needed it.
Troubles, I've got 'em too.
other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too. But none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny, 'cause you've got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. Oh, you've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, just remember what your old pal said, boy. You've got